28, and he has got many laurels in his career.
Bring in around 40 reputed international surgeons and authors to contribute for a textbook and co-author the textbook with his own mentor and teacher. This is one of the international textbooks. This is the one and only textbook where the logo will have an inscription of Meipurul Kanbadarivu for the Tirukural. I wish him all the success.
He has edited a book at this young age. Congratulations, my dear young man. Today, I had the opportunity to listen to Dr. Pragatheeshwar's lecture. I was immediately impressed with two things. One was the science and depth of his knowledge. And secondly, I was really impressed with the English. I have no words to describe this young man's outstanding work that he has. There are four people who have gotten Nobel Prize from India. Three of them are from Tamil Nadu. And that is something that we all have to be proud about. People talk about diabetes, hypertension, cancer. They talk about cancer as if it's a disease. Cancer is not one disease. It is thousands of diseases. Almost all specialties are concerned with cancer at some point. That there is a lot of, you know, information explosion in cancer. And there is a lot of confusion. I've seen so many patients who are confused. Patients would come to a doctor, he would say, no, you can do surgery. Another doctor would say, no, you don't have to do surgery, we'll do chemotherapy. One person would say, we'll give chemotherapy before surgery. One person would say, we'll give chemotherapy after surgery. So there's a lot of confusion. And that is the reason why in hospitals, like Apollo hospitals, they have a tumor board, wherein all the doctors come and speak at one place so that everybody can exchange their ideas. Even in the tumor board, there is confusion. We wanted to put an end to this problem, this confusion. And we wanted to choose a scientific method. What we did was we took all of the research studies in each field of cancer. Then we classified them according to the quality of the research done. And we grouped for each treatment or each method of diagnosis, what is the evidence that we have. And then we make our recommendations based on these evidences, solid proof. We have listed down all of the evidences and made our own recommendations in this book. So easily, anybody who buys this book, at the end of each chapter, you can go to the end of the chapter and you can see for each method of diagnosis or something, you can find out, okay, this is the level of evidence, so there won't be any confusion. And then this is the grade of recommendation, so that people can talk the same language. This wonderful book, and it also comes to the website, and the website will show you all the levels of evidence. So if a doctor wants, doesn't have the book in his clinic, wants to know what it is, he can just log on to the internet, take a look at it. We put about 1 year's effort in just reading the evidence and collecting it and compiling it. So we've created this beautiful book, right? But who is going to release the book? Who is the worthy person to release such a good book? I've traveled a couple of countries, and I'll tell you my humble insight is that there are only two things that we need to give the people. Just give them good healthcare and good education. People talk about eradicating poverty, business, trade, all these things. What we need to do is just give them good healthcare and good education. Automatically, everything will be fine. A lot of people think that in India, good education and good healthcare is not affordable. That is partly true, but there is a more important problem. Even for the people who can afford it, there is no good education and no good healthcare. The problem is not affordability, the problem is just availability. That is the biggest problem. And the first thing would be to make good healthcare and good education for the people who can afford it. Automatically, the affordability will increase within the population and more people will begin to consume it. And there are two people who have actually understood this concept well. Let's take, for example, Dr. Reddy. He is the pioneer in corporate healthcare in India. But now he owns the largest chain of corporate hospitals in India itself. He has brought in so many new technologies, and millions of people are going to his hospitals every day and are benefiting. He has brought the technology to affordability. He did not make the people affordable in India. If people are saying that survival and life expectancy has improved in the last few years, definitely without Dr. P.C. Reddy, it would have not happened. The next thing is education. Dr. Pachamuthu, he also, like Dr. Reddy, started from scratch. Today, he is educating 40,000 students. Not one, not two, not 100, not 1,000. He is educating 40,000 students in his SRM group of institutions. Just imagine how many students he's going to educate in the next in his lifetime. This is what one person can do. I mean, this is more than a particular organization or a government can do. So if this book, which has all these special qualities, has to be released, then it has to be released by the person who pioneered medical healthcare revolution in India, and it has to be received by the person who has pioneered educational revolution in India. Logo of this, the logo is actually shows one scalpel, which is for surgery. The other one is an yeritani to show that we are interested in academics, and the other one is a pipette, which is for research. These three are the core concepts of surgical oncology. Dr. Bartlett was kind enough to let me choose the caption. The entire thing of the book is to find out the truth, and so we chose a Tamil vakyam, which is Meipurul Kandavarigal, which means knowledge is seeking the truth. I also thank Mr. Abhay Nadarajan, who has offered us a detailed explanation and also helped us choosing it. I thank Mr. Arunesh Punita and Mr. Mathu Prasad from Apollo Hospitals. I thank all the teachers, my family, my friends. தென்னாடுடைய சிவனை போற்றி என்னாட்டவருக்கும் விரைவாக போற்றி வணக்கம்.